Oh, and welcome back. So we left off and we had to do the cooling and then wiring everything up to a seat. Finish off the fuel and air. Let go. Let's start with the fuel first. Let's turn it red. So we want the medium tanks. Actually, I might build a custom tank. Yeah, I think I'll do that. So that. I think that might be one too low. So yep, we'll do that. So what we will need. Report. Think we're gonna have to put a pump in. The spawner. The meter, fluid meter. So under sensors. See. There we go, fluid meter. So just turn this one off, is it? And all the way to the top. Needs to split. Change that. This is where I always get them muddled up. Fluid out. That's what the hell? Right. Fuel T pipe that fuel piece. And then this. To do the other side because I didn't put the symmetry thing back on. So this will be like the function section here. It'll be bit sticking out on top, unless I build the back of the cabin. I'm cooling. Right. I'm gonna try something I've not tried before, and that's seeing if I can fit the cooling inside here. I'm not sure. Or I could put it flat on top of the fuel tanks. Let's get the sorry for the silence. I can tell I'm trying to concentrate and see what I'm trying to do here. It's a bit of a tight squeeze, but I'm gonna get there. There we go. Is that one? So yeah, that's that. I think that looks pretty cool. So this little block here, the T section, obviously same as a car, it needs a tank to hold cold water. So that just needs to be changed to fresh water. Same with the other one. So that's pretty much our engine set up there. Got to put in the logic, which we can do now. We need one of those each. And this also combines with a gear change module. I don't have that one installed at the minute, so I have to go to the Steam and get that before we continue with setting up the gears. So with the these engines, as you can see, there's a lot of stuff to connect. Let's have a look. So engine one is going to be on the left side, engine two is going to be on the right side. Throttle air, do the same on this one. Throttle air. Throttle fuel. Clutch. To electric, so that's these ones here. This is to help start the motor. I'm also going to try and when I get these bigger, I will do it so it's more of a hybrid engine. So when I'm at cruise speed, I can turn off and switch on electric. Well, that's what I'm thinking at the moment. Start a motor. And these ones. For the speed. Let's connect the RPS on the crankshaft. So let's do that up there. RPS from the engine. I was asking for a speed sensor. That one connects to the radiator fan. So we just have this one to set to speed sensor. So let's get that. So we want the linear speed. There it is. Don't know if this will work for both, so let's try it anyway. linear speed, not so that should work. So we've got those to connect. We've got all our electrics to connect. So we're not connecting it to the alternator. We will both connect to that one, to that one, to that one. let's install a battery. Just gonna go for 2 medium. Maybe 1 per side. And what I might do is add a second, a third even. Up front there. That's a backup battery of sorts. So back to the electric. So we want it to generator to go to there. So alternators are exactly the same as generators. They make take power from the engine and recharge your battery. And that's all you really want from those. And then the batteries will connect through a switch, which will be in the cab. So pumps will be on a separate button. Radiators are controlled by the NJ ECU. What I will also do is pick both of those to go to that one. So those will both charge all three batteries. Will charge all three batteries. Yeah, that's all looking good now. So we've just got these to hitch up in a bit. And as you can see, that's to go to the automatic transmission I was saying about that MJ did. So I'll have to go to this workshop and upload that. Or download that, whichever you want to call it. Transmission data. Connect to seat. Right. So I will go do that in a sec and download that and add it. But for now, let's continue building our boat. So money's getting a bit short already. And also do a lot of the upgrades to this one, like bow thrusters, better movement, and Yeah, I plan to do a lot with this boat. I want to make it, I'll make it bigger at some point, which will be quite easy because it's a fuel tank's in the middle and there's nothing else there. I can just like cut around here, make it longer, use blocks to connect them and paste it together, merge it. So this is our air. Don't want to make it look too boxy, but I might have to just deal with it because we're running out of cash quite fast. So we're going to have an entrance either side from that. Let's get a seat. Actually, I'm going to do something different. I've not used it much before. I'm going to use the helm. No, I'm not. I'm gonna use a seat. I like seats. And, we're gonna need some benches. Do those in a bit actually. Let's just sure what I'm going to do with the window at the front yet. I don't want it to be square. this wall here will be the items to go on, like the welders and things like that, first aid kit. There will be a downstairs, which I'm probably going to do at the front, and put a bit of stairs and then a door down there, or a hatch. Sheet data. Sheet data. So that will go to the transmission and a readout dial. So yeah, I'm going to go download that microcontroller. So next time we will hopefully get that up and running and be able to test our car. Our car? Or boat? Yep, it's definitely a boat. So here's what it looks like so far. I'll also have a think about what to do with the front windows. So that's all for next time. Thanks for watching. See you later. Bye.